sahanavavatu sahanam bhunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvinavadhitamastu mavidvishavahai. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Samasta Jana Kalyane, Niratam Karunamayam, Namami Chinmayam Devam, Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram. Hari Om. So we have learnt using a support how to make the mind quiet. We did Om chanting, we also did the Ishta Mantra, and we did the Gayatri Mantra. One can use any one, any combination one likes, or none of these, and use any other support, that is up to us. Important is that the support must make it must engage our emotion, because the mind will wander if emotion is not engaged. So whichever support one uses. Now making the mind quiet itself is a big step in one's evolution and meditation. And many people may stop with that. Many people may feel nice about that. But one has to go further. Any transformation we want to bring about in our personality, at the personality level, and even from the Vedantic standpoint, to transcend the personality, calming the mind is the first step. Before we go on to the understanding of Vedanta and contemplating on our true nature as Brahman, etc., our daily life has to get into order. So in our culture, we have what we call as Shanti Mantra. Shanti Mantra means, literally it means peace invocation, like what we chanted just now, Sahana Vavatu. These are called, or these also serve as what they call in modern language as positive affirmations. These positive affirmations are very important to transform our thought process. Because all of us have what we call a self-talk. We talk with ourselves. And our self-talk needs to be positive to be secure, to achieve anything we want to achieve in life, to be confident, to be cheerful, to be happy. If the self-talk is negative, then I don't like myself, I am insecure, there are fears, there are anxieties, there is low confidence, all that happens. So we will be using today, we will understand the importance of a positive affirmation. When the mind has been made quiet, see, a mantra itself is a positive affirmation by itself. So I don't need a separate positive affirmation to be done. But in case I need to handle a specific issue, then I can use it. So if I say Gayatri Mantra, that itself is a positive affirmation where I'm saying that I'm meditating on the effulgence of that sun which illumines the whole universe. May our intellects be bright and brilliant. So I am doing a positive affirmation with every chanting, telling myself that I am invoking brightness in my life, brilliance in my life, abundance in my life. So a mantra itself can do that. But if I have a specific thought process that I want to reverse, it may be related to my health, it may be related to a certain belief pattern that people don't love me, it may be related to a feeling of being victimized, anything. It could be a particular fear which I want to reverse. in a calm and a quiet mind, I need to send that affirmation, repeat that affirmation, and feel the power of that. The subconscious belief system and emotion attached to that will get changed. I don't know too much about this, but there are people who tell me that neuro-linguistic programming works. There's a part of neuro-linguistic programming is this. We're using particular sentences and specific expressions and words, the conditioning is reversed. So in our culture, it used to be done with Shanti mantras. One can use Shanti mantras if one likes, or any Ishta mantra, or even one can use statements in English. One has to frame for oneself. These are the things, this is a statement that I want to affirm to myself. Literally, what is the meaning of an affirmation? An affirmation is, it comes from the word affirm. It means to emphasize or to reiterate, to assert. And it is that one particular thought that I want to affirm, to assert again and again and again, so that it goes deep and it will transform my thought process. So these affirmations are very, very powerful. And if I identify, so these affirmations are not only to change my belief pattern from what I hold as negative to make it positive. Even if I want to achieve something, a statement, that's my goal, to inspire myself to reach that, I can use affirmation. So it's not only meant for from negative to positive transformation. It can help me to achieve my goal, my desires, whatever I need to achieve. Where they would say that one has to visualize that one has already achieved that and feel, suppose I want to become a very healthy person. Maybe I have been having sickness, or I want to lose weight, or I want to have certain promotion, certain abundance, certain prosperity, whatever that goal is. Then one has to visualize that. One has to feel one has achieved that. The logic behind that is that the mind does not know what is the difference between inside and outside. Example, suppose this bottle is there. Now you are seeing this bottle. When you are seeing this bottle, if we were to map your brain and find out which are the areas that are lighting up, there will be certain areas that will light up. Then this recognition of this bottle happens. If you close your eyes and now visualize this bottle, it is very amazing. Same areas of the brain will light up. So the brain really doesn't know the difference between inside and outside. Which is what Vedanta has been saying, that the whole world is actually a projection of the mind. This division of inside and outside is created because of this body. There is no such division otherwise. From the body standpoint, when I'm looking, then I feel this is inside and this everything else is outside. But the brain doesn't work like that. Everything is experienced by the brain in itself. And so what I see outside is also experienced inside. What I imagine inside in the brain also is experienced inside only. So if I'm visualizing that I have already achieved that goal, I'm feeling as though I have accomplished that, then those same areas will light up, which means that it will push me towards achieving that. Hence, these positive affirmations, they have a certain specific features and how to use these positive affirmations. So first and foremost, we make the mind quiet, invoke whatever you believe in, God, Guru, infinite energy, a higher source of inspiration. And when that mind has become quiet, we send a specific positive affirmation within the mind by repeating that and trying to feel what it conveys. So here we are having a list of some of the positive affirmations. You can make your own also. If we can just distribute this, please. So it's a strong positive statement written in present tense, which is an affirmation which will make firm what I want to do, what I want to achieve, but in present tense, as though I have already achieved it. So some of this we have given, we have categorized that for about oneself, about the health, about relationships, about work, about prosperity, and about spirituality. Few affirmations which one has written here. Now these affirmations, they can replace the old thoughts, negative thought patterns. They can create security in the mind. They can also create new channels of thinking and inspire me to achieve what I want to achieve. And very important is the affirmation keeps me on track of my goal. That's why in any personality development seminar, etc., you will find, they will tell you, write down your goal and keep reading that again and again and again. Because that keeps the mind focused. Okay, this is what I need to achieve. And distractions eliminated, many things move aside. So now these affirmations, if you see some of these, if we understand some of the features of an affirmation, we can make our own affirmation. First and foremost, it must be in the present tense. Because the mind does not understand future, it will understand now. So I have to, if I say that one day I will be prosperous, it is not as impactful as I am prosperous. And I have to feel and visualize that prosperity. You may feel sometimes it is fake. But I'm not prosperous now. How can I feel I'm prosperous? But the future we want to create for ourselves, every creation happens first in the mind, then outside or not. Any creation. I mean, if you are attending this class today, you have a thought in the mind first, you know, I have to attend. Sunday morning, 9:30, I have to be there. And you sustain that thought. And then the action happens. So if I understand this logic very well, and if I understand, so the two logics are one that the brain doesn't know difference between inside and outside. So what I see inside, it will manifest it outside. The energy has to be given to that, that's all. And second logic is this, that this just now I said that second logic, what was that? The affirmation is in the present tense because the mind doesn't understand about the future, and what I think is what I will bring about. So if a person has understood this, even if you don't feel fully about it, whatever feeling you are able to harness towards that, start with that. Suppose you are not well. If you feel that I am healthy, you visualize yourself being healthy, the body will move towards that. They also call it law of attraction in different terminology, that there will be messages you will receive, or your mind will be open to getting to be able to assimilate those messages, and they will come, they will transform their life. So these affirmations, one is they should be in a positive, in a present tense. One should not phrase it in a future tense. Second aspect is, no negatives can be used. Gurudev used to tell us, mind does not know what not to do, mind only knows what to do. So I cannot say that I should not be angry. It will not work. Because the mind does not emphasize should not. Mind only focuses on anger. So I'm going to strengthen anger even if I say I should not be angry. So I will need to make it in a positive tone, saying that I am more compassionate. I am more accommodative. I am more empathetic. So one is present tense, one is being, it has to be phrased in a positive language. Third is the simpler and the shorter the affirmation, the better is the impact. Because the mind can invoke more feeling towards that. Long, long sentences, big, big paragraphs, very difficult. Focus won't be there. Hence, one sentence we have given here. The stronger one feels about it, the greater will be the change. You may find certain resistance to that. Suppose same issue of anger. So if I say that I am more compassionate and accommodative, or I am forgiving somebody, I'm so and so, I forgive so and so, and I'm sending positive vibrations and love to that person. Now the resistance may come, but that person doesn't even deserve all this. All the time that person keeps on doing this to me, and why should I send positive? Don't worry. Don't justify it, don't resist it, just keep sending, keep focused on the affirmation. Because that resistance is a result of my own conditioning. If I fight it, I am going to strengthen it. If I am going to encourage that, these affirmations are not going to work. So leave it alone. Any distractions and any resisting thoughts that come along, don't do anything with them. Just leave them alone as it is. Focus only on that positive affirmation. Then when I use this affirmation, if I associate a picture with that, affirmation will invoke more feeling. So I have to picturize it. It can't only be a sentence. So if I want to be compassionate, I need to visualize, especially if it is with a particular person, I have to visualize relating with that person in a positive way. Whether that person is responding positively or not is not my worry. And if you feel convinced, even if that person is responding negatively, your visualization has to be in spite of that, you are still being able to relate positively and peacefully. That visualization is important there. Because we understood that a few classes back, that mind thinks more in terms of pictures and less in terms of words. Hence these positive affirmations, they work. And the last aspect of this is, I must believe that this works, which in our culture we always call as faith. That the Shraddha has to be there, and over a period of time one will see the transformation happening. Whatever level of Shraddha one can bring into it, if it is less, doesn't matter. Start with that and it will happen. So now, having understood this, if we just go through these affirmations that are given, I'm not going to go through all of them, but let us say two, three in each category. So positive affirmations about myself. So every day, in every way, I am getting better, better and better. Very general positive affirmation, that I am progressing, I am getting better. Because many people think that we will grow by finding our flaws. This is not right, that is not right, this should be better, that should be like this. So the assertion or the self-talk that is happening within me is a constant negative self-talk, which is only focusing on how much, what I am not good at, or what is not right, or what should have been different. And if a person cannot focus on the positive, the self-love will not happen. And though that self-love is not there, then a lot of other problems happen. Dependency, insecurity, fear, and many things. So about myself, these statements, if you see, they are to make me more secure and make me love myself and visualize positivity in my life. So everything is coming to me easily and effortlessly. This is to reverse the conditioning, because some people think that my life is a war. Everything I have to fight for is a struggle. And it may be, I'm not saying no, there may be some struggles, everybody's life there is some struggle. But somewhere the mind becomes conditioned to fight. Even when there is nothing to fight, one wants to, one is a resisting mode, fighting mode. So if I tell this to myself, that things are coming to me easily, effortlessly, I don't have to struggle and, you know, make everything into a war situation. I have everything I need to enjoy my life here and now. This is to be happy with what I have, to be content, and to feel blessed. No, but then how will we progress in life? Because of this, one will progress much more. Because the mind which is calm has so many more creative ideas, will be able to execute. So you can go through some of this. Very important one is the 8th one. I love myself and I love to love and be loved. This will bring us the emotional security. That I love myself and I am happy. I love to love people also. Makes me more and more secure. Whether people respond to my love in a way I want or not, doesn't matter. I still love and I give love. So some of these, like about health, coming to health now. I am looking and feeling healthy. My senses are sensitized and sharp. I have all the energy required to achieve everything I want. You know, affirmation also works in such a way that it will bring a specific focus into my life. So if I don't have everything, don't have energy to achieve everything I want, it will set me thinking in my daily life, what do I need to do for this now? At physical level or mental level, if I'm dissipating energy, so how can I block, how can I conserve? About relationships, my relationship with so-and-so is growing happier and more fulfilling every day. I am becoming more and more selfless in my relationships. I am grateful to God for all my relationships. Any of these. Third one is a very nice one. My relationships are mirrors to enlightenment. Especially when we are spiritual seekers, we may feel the relationships are a bondage. You know, ye sab chhod chhad ke chale jayenge. Go somewhere and be peaceful and quiet somewhere. Nothing works. If I can't be happy amidst the people I am living and learn to make my mind free of rag and dvesh, wherever else I will go, it will create new rag and dvesh. And the more difficult challenges, more difficult, so-called difficult people I have, the faster is my spiritual evolution. Just I read one nice incident somebody shared. You know, they said that these Japanese people, they like to eat a particular type of fish which is found on the coast of Australia. I don't know the name, I forgot. Some Australian coast, there is some particular type of fish. So they used to import. So when they import that fish, by the time it comes to them, it becomes very stale. They don't like, they still buy, eat it, but the market, that feeling was ki if we get fresh, it will be so much better. So what did they do? They started having aquarium in the ship and put the take the fish with that water, keep there, bring it, and then they will sell it. That was much better than that stale fish which used to come. Still, they felt they could improve. So what did they do? In that aquarium, they put a shark. And that shark, when it was put there, that shark will eat away 20% of the fish. But because that shark is there, that 80% of the fish which are surviving, they are constantly in a mode of alertness, just like they are in the ocean. Now, if you are put in the aquarium, then that danger is not there, so they are not moving as they used to in the ocean. So these Japanese people said, this shark, if we put, we will lose 20% of the fish, doesn't matter, but this fish, 80% will be so much more fresher, and they made more profit on that. And that anecdote ends with that, saying that, thank God for all the sharks that are there in your life. They keep you more active and alive. So if there are such people, and we find it difficult to deal with them, it is up to us how we recondition our mind. And so, relationships are my mirrors to enlightenment. So if I have this feeling that, you know, these relationships are binding me and my sadhana is not happening well, and, you know, I feel I should have gone away from all these, or I should go away, this will help us to recondition the mind. About the job, I am doing what I love and loving what I do. I am relaxed at work. I have plenty of time for everything. This really works. Because most of the time we go on thinking time nahi hai, time nahi hai, time nahi hai. And interesting thing is that the person who is efficient has a lot of work, and more work is dumped on that person, and still the person will find time. And the person who is not efficient, even if that work is given is lesser, still that person will go on fretting and fuming, there is no time, there is no time, there is no time. So I have plenty of time. See, many of these are to recondition my false psychological patterns I have in my mind. They are not to have unrealistic expectations. These are to recondition my thought process where I have held a wrong psychological belief. All my colleagues are in tune with me and I am in tune with them. Very important one for leadership and team building. That how can I be in tune with my people and how can my people be in tune with me? I am achieving my goal, whatever it is, in my professional life, and I visualize that. About prosperity, I am prosperous and having abundance of wealth. Every day I am growing more and more prosperous. The more I have, the more I am giving and sharing. My life is abundant in all areas. Thinking of abundance brings more abundance. Thinking of having not enough and wanting much, much more, out of that feeling of comparison or insecurity, can get me somewhere, but I can't feel secure and positive about that. So it's a myth to say that, you know, many people say greed is good, you should be discontented. These are all myths. Unnecessarily they have been planted in our minds. We must get out of those. Shankaracharya said, yallabhase nija karmo patam vittam tena vinodaya chittam. With whatever one has got, be content and happy, and then strive based on that. That is out of security and creativity. Coming to the spiritual aspect is the subtlest one, that I am divine, I am peace, I am bliss, which we say in our this shlokas and mantras. I am meditating well. The light of truth shines through me and I surrender to it. My life is guided by the divine. Any of these can be used. Spiritual aspects, we will come to it from the next session when we do contemplation. So these are the different positive affirmations which one can use. One can use also a Shanti mantra. You can choose any of these which you like. You can create your own positive affirmation that you want. In our Vedic literature, every Veda has one prominent Shanti mantra. And these Shanti mantras are for the holistic growth. So the Sahana Bhavatu that we chant, that Sahana Bhavatu is from the Yajurveda. Then we have this Bhadram Karnebhi Shunuyama Devaha, that is from the Atharva Veda. Many of you will know that, because any film, any serial, if they have to do any ritual, they will just stand Bhadram Karne Vishnu Yamadeva. Whether that is applicable there or not doesn't matter, but start Bhadram Karne Bhi. It's a positive Shanti mantra, saying that may I listen to what is auspicious, may I hear, see what is auspicious, may all my limbs be healthy. It goes like that. Apyayantu Mamangani is from the Sama Veda. And Purnamada Purnamidam is from the Rig Veda. So whether you know it or not, you have been chanting two Shanti mantras regularly. Sahana Bhavatu to begin with and Purnamada to end. So today we will use the Shanti mantra Sahana Bhavatu. In English, you want to create your own affirmations, you are welcome to create and keep using it as you want, but just For today, we will be using Sahana Bhavatu as our Shanti Mantra. So we will follow the same process till we invoke the Guru and the Ishta, and then we use the Sahana Bhavatu mantra as our positive affirmation. Right.